Now let's see what an interface is and its declaration. Now interfaces are nothing, it is actually a pure abstract class only, right? Which by default contains all methods as an abstract method, right? And an interface, as I talk about methods, whether we're gonna mention the keyword as abstract or not, all methods will still gonna remain as abstract, right? So interfaces will always gonna remain abstract, whether we're gonna mention it or not. And in order to declare an interface in Java, we use a keyword called as interface, right? So normally when you work on an Eclipse, when you work in Eclipse, then in order to create an interface, let's say I create a new package for interface. I'll say, just give me a moment. I'll right click, say package, and say interface example. Right. And what I'm going to do, I'll create a new, like the way we create class, we create an interface. Now, let's say if I talk about web driver is an interface. So if I click on finish, this is what. How an interface looks like. And similarly, I can create a couple of methods over here, like click. If I try to define the method, it will gonna throw an error immediately. So you can see abstract method do not specify a body. See, I have not written abstract over here. So by default, the method inside an interface are abstracts. You can add a keyword over here. You can say public abstract. ABSTRACT, yeah, abstract. You can add a keyword, but if you don't add a keyword, by default, all the methods will be abstract. So you can create a couple of methods, public void, click, public void, send keys, right? But you cannot create any concrete methods inside an interface. Like in case of abstract class, we were able to create concrete method as well as an abstract method, but in case of an interface, the methods will always be abstract. Similarly, like we are not able to create an object of an abstract class. Same way over here, if I create a test class with a main method, I'll not be able to create an object of an interface. I cannot say web driver equal to new web driver. So Java won't allow me to do this. So you can say it cannot instantiate the type web driver. So this is not possible. This is the same thing that we have seen in case of an abstract class as well, right? So the only difference in abstract class and an interface is that in interface, all methods are by default abstract, whereas in case of an abstract class, we can create an abstract method as well as a concrete method. The other thing is that we cannot create an interface final, right? This is same thing with an abstract class as well, where we have created abstract class, we cannot create it as final. Because if we create an abstract class or an interface as final, we cannot override the methods that are written, that are declared over here. The abstract methods, we cannot override them, right? So this is the reason we cannot create interfaces or abstract class with a fine keyword. So normally interfaces are used to create requirement. Now if we want to standardize our project, if we want that all the child classes should actually gonna implement the same functionality, then only we create an interface. So like in abstract class, it's mandatory for all the child classes to overwrite the abstract methods. Same way, if any class is implementing the interface, it should actually provide definition to all the methods which are there inside the interface. Now, for example, if I create a class over here, I'll create the class with the name as Firefox driver. Now, if this Firefox driver class want to inherit web driver interface, so the keyword that is used as implements. So we're going to say implements WebDriver. If a class inherit a class, then we create we add a keyword at extends. If a class is inheriting an interface, then we need to add a keyword as implements. And you can see the same message that we got in case of abstract classes. We are getting the same method. Firefox driver must implement the inherited abstract methods of WebDriver. Send case. If you click over here, same thing will happen. Both click and send keys are added over here. The method body is added over here with @override annotation is added over here. Right now, if an interface inherits an interface, let's say I create another interface, let's say I name it as remote web driver. So over here, if an interface inherits an interface, then we need to add a keyword called as extends. So this remote web driver extends web driver. Now you can see the error is not coming. This is like the same way. If abstract class is extending the abstract class, the error will not gonna come, right? But if any concrete class is going to extend it, then the error will gonna come. Same way, if any child class, if any class is implementing that interface, then you're gonna face that error and you need to add all the unimplemented methods. You need to provide definition to those methods. Now, let's say I create some methods inside some this remote web driver interface. So I've created a method called as window maximize, something like this. Right, which will actually going to maximize the window. Now, if I create another class, and if any class, let's say a class called as Chrome driver, if this class, it implements remote web driver interface, then what all methods it will be overriding? It will be overriding methods from the current interface as well as the parent interface of this remote web driver. So if you go over here, if you mouse over and if you click on add an implemented method, you're going to see it will actually going to implement all the unimplemented methods inside the child class, right? This is the same thing that we have seen in abstract classes as well. Now if I create another class which will be like a child class of this Chrome driver class, so I'll name it as Chrome driver child, right? Now if this class also if this class extends, let's say Chrome driver, so will it gonna implement the methods from remote web driver or from web driver? No. Right, because all the methods are already implemented inside the parent class, that is Chrome driver. If I don't do it over here, then we'll immediately get an error over here itself in the Chrome driver implementation. Right, so why we are getting error over here? Because it's mandatory that the first concrete child should actually implement all the methods, all the inherited methods from the interface or from the abstract class, right? Because we cannot declare, let's say abstract methods over here. If we declare them, then the class has to be abstract, right? So we actually need to define all the methods. We need to override all the methods inside the first child class itself. All right. Otherwise, you need to create it as an abstract class. And if you, an abstract class can also implement interface, right? A class can implement the interface. And as soon as you save this without implementing the methods, the immediate concrete class has to provide definition to all these methods. All right. So let me remove this and let me remove this abstract keyword from here. All right. Now, there is an important concept to understand over here. In case of inheritance, we know that the multiple inheritance is not possible in case of child. As in, the child cannot have multiple parents. The child class cannot extend multiple parent class. Why this is not possible? We have already seen, just like we have already seen in case of inheritance, where let's say if there are multiple parent classes, and if a child class extends, let's say, just give me a moment. Let's say these two are parent classes. And this is a child class, right? Now this child class, let's say it extends the parent class, parent one as well as parent two, right? So this is like the parent one, parent class one, and this is parent class two. Right. Now, let's say this thing is called as multiple inheritance, right? So this is not feasible in Java because Java does not allow multiple inheritance. This is because, let's say, there's a method called as show inside this class, and there is a method called as show inside the parent class as well. And even the child class has got the method as show. Now, if the child class already have a method show, and if we create an object of a child class, new child, and if we call the method as show, which method will be called? As per inheritance tree, the very first the method that will be called is of the child class itself. Now, what if the child class does not have the show method? Then which method will be called? Will the method of parent one will be called, or will the method of parent two will be called? So here the Java will get confused, and that is where the ambiguity will gonna come. So this thing is actually solved with the help of interface, right? Why? Because in interface, let's say instead of creating this as a class, I'll create them as interface. So this is interface one, and this is interface two. Now this class is actually implementing both the interfaces. Now as soon as this child class, it implements the parent one interface, what all methods that are there inside the parent class, the interface, this child class has to define that method. So we need to give the body to that method. Right. So the definition that will gonna come is of the child, and you know that in interfaces all the methods are abstract, so there is no definition provided in the interfaces, in the methods inside interfaces. So at any point of time the ambiguity will not gonna come, because the method, when we say new child dot show, the method that will gonna come is from the child class only and not from the parent class. Right, so this is one of the interview question, how multiple inheritance is possible in Java, because Java does not allow multiple inheritance. It can be achieved with the help of interfaces only, because in interfaces we don't define the body of a method, right? The definition is provided in the child class, and as per the inheritance tree, if you create an object of the child class, the very first method will be called is of the child class, and there is no way in interface, if a child is implementing any interface, there is no way that the child class can avoid defining the method which are there, the abstract method which are there in the interface. There is no way. So a child has to implement that method, and whenever you create an object of the child, then the method that will be called is from the child itself, right? So these are very important concepts. Now let's implement this thing. Now what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna first create an interface with the name as, let's say I'll name it as parent one for the time, and another interface name as parent two. Right, now both interfaces has got a method that is public void show. Right. And I'll add this method over here as well. Right. Now if I create a class called as child, let's say child one. Now a class cannot extend more than one parent, but a class can implement more than one interface. Means a child class cannot extend more than one parent class, right? A child one can only extend the parent one class or a parent two, but it cannot extend both the parent classes. But over here, these are not classes, these are interfaces. So in case of interface, it is possible. If I say parent one, and if I want to extend the second one as well, I can say parent two. So child one implements parent one and parent two, and if you click over here, the show method will actually going to belong to the child class, and here you can provide the definition to this method, right? So this show implementation will going to satisfy the parent one as well as the parent two, right? We need not to implement show method twice, right? We only need to implement it once. Now if I provide definition to this method, I'll say child show. Now if I call this method, there has to be a main method, and where I need to create an object of this class. I'll say child one c equal to new child one, and if I say c dot show, and if I run this, you're gonna see the method is called. Same thing, instead of this, I can take the reference of parent one or parent two as well, right? So the reference could be of any parent, right? Interface. Now what if there is a class as well, like we have parent interface, I'm gonna create a parent class one, which has also got the same method, that is public void show, and this is coming from the parent show, right? Now if this child extends the parent class as well, we can extend the parent class along with the interface. So you can see it is actually throwing an error over here, because the class first extends parent class one, right? So I have written the incorrect name. So this we cannot do it over here, right? After this we cannot do it. It will run through an error. So first it extends and then it implements, right? Now if I run this thing again, so the child method is called, because as per inheritance tree, the method which is there in the child class will be called first. If I'll remove this method from here, you can see we are not getting any error, because this method is already defined in the parent class. If I remove this from here, then the child class will gonna throw an error. Right, then you need to overwrite this method over here. Otherwise, if this is already done in the parent class, and now if you call it, the method from the parent class will be shown. Right? So you can see all polymorphism and inheritance, all these things are interrelated. Right? So this is one of the best example to see both the things at the same place. And including the multiple inheritance that we were talking about. So multiple inheritance is not possible at the class level. It is actually possible at the interface level. Right. So just go through these concepts very carefully. These are very, very important. At times working on a framework, or at times you are accessing or using any API, these things are very important. All right. Thank you.